Hi everyone, this is Don from Loqheart. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to prepare a Flash FLA for export into Spriteloq. Here we have a character that was created by David for a game that we're working on. We have a bomb that walks around, gets angry, and explodes. Let's see how this guy was put together. So in our library, we have our bomber, and he's made up of a bunch of symbols that represent each of his body parts. They were animated on the timeline using classic tweens and keyframes. And each of the animations was named using frame labels. So this is going to be really useful for us because setting it up this way, we can see all the animations. And we can use our splits by frame name extension in order to split up this timeline, which will then give us the individual clips for the animations. So here we have the walk, and as you can see, it's separated from all the other animations. And the reason why we're doing this is because Spriteloq works on individual SWFs. So each of these animations will turn into a single sprite animation that we'll use in Corona. We're just about ready to export all of these SWFs, but we want to make sure to ignore our bomber character, because he has all of our animations on the timeline here. Instead, we just want to export these individual animations. So we do that by creating an ignore folder and then putting all of the body parts as well as the main animation in there. And with that done, we can run the export library of SWFs command. We're going to save them to our assets folder here. And as you can see from the output, they're all exported and ready for loading into Spriteloq. So another thing to note while you're exporting your SWFs is to make sure that your project is actually an AS3 project. Spriteloq won't be able to load in AS2 or ActionScript 2 SWFs, and it can't load in ActionScript 1 SWFs either. So as long as your FLA can be converted to AS3 and then exported, we'll be able to load your SWFs into Spriteloq without any problems. Thanks for watching.